in trading. This is the industry where people fail a lot. And that was kind of a challenge because there are some, if all are failing, I'm not interested. If some are succeeding, then how?
The trading system, based on statistics and probabilities, will tell you exactly how much you can risk. And only after that, we can discuss about the risk appetite, because you can take that risk, you can take a lower risk if you want.
It has to be emotionless.
This is crazy. It has to be boring, guys.
Yeah.
If you have feelings, if your heart is pumping just like this, if you take decisions, just hear this out. You can never, ever, ever, ever will be able to say that you have an edge in the market.
Started the mentoring program. I was lucky. I found the trading busters, and every person sees trading differently. Some sees this as like an escape out of matrix. Some sees it as a legit investment. And you know, number one rule in investing is preserve the capital, and that's managing the risk. Best aid against the fear is the information. And we don't have the information if we don't have statistics.
Hello everyone, today we have with us Aivis, a member into my mentoring program, and maybe you saw already Aivis into an interview that we did a few months ago. If you didn't, you can go on my YouTube channel and watch that interview. You have a lot to learn from that interview. And basically, yesterday Aivis came to Bucharest to stay with us for 2 days at the office, and we say like, why not? Let's do a short podcast to see his evolution through the mentoring program. I'll let Aivis, if it's first time when you see it, to introduce himself, and then we can start with like some questions and some small talks about trading and how everything is going.
Hi everyone, my name is Aivis and I'm from Latvia. Thank you, George, for inviting me and being so for the nice hospitality, a nice atmosphere in the Bucharest, in the office. Everything is very, very nice here. I've been in mentoring for 9 months.
That's something.
I have been through all the materials, not only one time, which just shows how serious I am about this. And I need to learn every single small piece in detail, because every detail counts in this industry. You cannot miss anything. Otherwise, you can be surprised. You know what I mean?
Exactly. Like, small things matter a lot. And it would be a shame not to go as many times as possible and not to have as many Zoom meetings as possible with a mentor to be able to solve all these unclear things, because, you know, it doesn't matter how hard I'm trying to explain everything in the videos.
Exactly.
I'm 100% sure that will be all the time, you know, people that maybe they didn't understand what I wanted to say in that video, but with the help of the mentor, you can cover those things that are missing.
At the beginning it's like weird if you compare to other programs, because this was not the first time I've been doing some courses in trading. So I was not coming into the field, this field from blank zero. It was a bit easier and faster for me to grasp everything that was in the course. But mentor here is very, very needed. Because as George just said, you can just misinterpret what was said in the first. This is so different how the rest of the world and most traders around are trading.
This is also a thing, you know, it's like, you definitely need a mentor because it's a new concept. Aivis can confirm that.
I was one of the loudest speakers about that. This new concept, as I said, it's not real, but it is very, very real, because it's like it works amazingly, and it's very consistent. And only profitable traders know what consistency means.
Yes, because Aivis, you can confirm, you know, and you can also see, guys, you know, in the payouts that our students get from their founder account that they get in Funding Dynasty, like, you don't see there, like, huge amount of profits, you know. A lot of, if you go online and see that, you see those huge payouts,
20,000%.
When you watch and you can scroll back in our Telegram channel and see that, you know, there are people that have like $400 withdrawals, like profit split, 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, 5,000, but nothing spectacular, you know, nothing like 20,000, 30,000 and stuff like that, because this trading concept is not at all about make huge gains, like within 1 month or things like this. It's just about consistency. And like, make money in a predictable way, and that's it. It's not at all about
making in the end, you're not here like for 1 or 2 months. Markets are not going to disappear. You look long term, and over time, and time goes very quickly. It adds up, stacks up very good, because it's consistent. And there is, I haven't seen any other program that you can be so consistent.
Yeah, because most of the people, I mean, like, we also had this discussion yesterday, I was by the window, regarding why this industry has such a bad reputation.
Exactly.
Because of this type of, you know, content that, you know, gurus like me, I'm a guru, okay, I'm in this industry as an influencer, so influencer, guru, whatever you want to call it. But most of them, you know, are only show those type of huge profits. You buy a Ferrari after 1 month of trading, you double, triple your account and so on. And that's why people come into this industry and they basically expect to for real make those type of profits. And guess what? It's possible. I mean, like, you can make $1 billion maybe within 1 hour. Theoretically, it's possible.
Well, you can also make this in roulette as well.
Exactly. I mean, like, you can make so much money. You can double, triple your account and so on, like the industry is telling you on, like, social media, lifestyle and so on. But what they don't tell you is that this type of huge gains come out only from the exactly same amount of risk. And what does that mean? That means if you double your account in one trade and so on, that means that the risk was big enough in order for you to lose that account in the exactly same way. So that's why people come with this mindset and they believe you can make so much money so quick and ended up in the rat race by losing everything, top up their account again, yeah, or buy another challenge, lose another challenge, buy another one, lose another one, and so on. Don't forget, I also have my own profile, Funding Dynasty. So I know how many people fail their challenge because of lack, because of the lack of the consistency. That's the only reason. So, Aivis, tell me a little about you know, about maybe your process with the.
With the mentoring,
yeah. With the mentoring, you know,
or trading in general, how I got into trading in the first place. Maybe that's the best way, because many people they are not in trading at all. They maybe consider to get into that. And let's say I was blessed, but actually this was just a logical decision to choose to join George's approach because of a lot of nonsense I have seen in the industry. And how I decided to get into the trading in the first place was not to quit the job quickly. And the idea was to make some extra income, a consistent way. Very important that was actually that was like a challenge where people fail a lot in trading. This is the industry where people fail a lot. And that was kind of challenge because there are some, if all are failing, I'm not interested. If some are succeeding, then how? Why are, do they have like four arms, four legs? No, they're also human. And that was kind of a challenge. And that kind of challenged me. Not because I like my job. I'm a tax auditor in huge corporation. I still keep the job. But this challenge was very important just to see how capable you need to be, how much hard work you need to put in, because this is not going to be easy. Definitely, you know, from your experience, and everyone who has been following George for some time knows his story, and the recovery is very, very motivating. And if George could do that, me without suffering such losses and being through the failures and this emotional strain, that's nothing for me if I start. I started the mentoring program. I was lucky. I found the trading busters, and every person sees trading differently. Some sees this as like an escape out of matrix. Some sees it as a legit investment. And you know, number one rule in investing is preserve the capital, and that's managing the risk. And this, and how to know how to manage risk is no better than having proper stats.
Exactly.
And I like this idea, this concept, because some people say that trading is controlled gambling because you can't predict the markets. I don't like to compare trading to gambling or any other casinos kind of stuff, but many people are doing, and I still get other people that knows that I'm trade saying to me that, what are you doing? And they have no idea what this concept is about and what this mentoring has taught me. It's been covering all of this stuff, how to get the edge in the market, how to preserve the capital. And let's start with the mindset at the very beginning, at why we are here. It's not
exactly,
for one day.
Because I mean, like, trading is not that much about strategy. Guys. Trading is about, like I would say, I really say that a good one, but you know, trading is about preserving capital and then make money. All the time, the capital, it has to be on the first place, you know. Someone say once, like, you know, the best investment that you can do is not invest anything. Just keep the money that way, okay? Anyway, it's inflation, dear, and so on. We don't discuss that much about that. But you need to first preserve your capital. How? Just think about how many of you, you know, let's say maybe started 1 year ago, and think about the capital that you started with and how much money you put already into your trading account and lose them. Let's say if you put $1,000 in your account and you lost them, now if you put another $1,000 in your account, you need to make $1,000 back just to be on break even, guys.
Yeah.
All right? Think about this. If you could preserve those $1,000, okay? If you could preserve that $1,000, so trade in a consistent way that $1,000 and be on break even, if you make $1 now profit, you'll make more money than did in 1 year, right? So maybe, hopefully this is makes sense for you, but preserving the capital, it's very important. And you can do this only if you know the probabilities of your trading system, because if you know the probabilities, that means you can apply not a good risk management. The risk management has to be perfect. There is no room for interpretation there. Yes. Failings that you know exactly how much you can risk. So the trading system, like Aivis can confirm, will tell you exactly how much you can risk with that trading system. It's not about your risk appetite. It's not at all. It's not about that you have a risk account and so on. All right. So first, the trading system, based on statistics and probabilities, will tell you exactly how much you can risk. And only after that, we can discuss about the risk appetite, because you can take that risk, you can take a lower risk if you want. So only from that point, you can discuss about risk appetite and all this stuff. And regarding gambling, you know, so many people in the industry say, okay, trading is gambling. Look, I don't have a problem with people saying this, discussers with Aivis yesterday, this, that I don't have a problem at all. Okay, trading is gambling, no problem. But just think about this: who is winning all the time in gambling? The house, the casinos, guys. The casinos are winning all the time in gambling. Let's take, for example, the roulette. You know, you go to the roulette, and people believe they have like 50-50 chances to win. No, it's totally wrong, because you have also zero and double zero.
Yeah.
And that put the casino to 52.7% for 52.5%, if I'm not mistaken, 52.5% chance to win, and the gambler 47.5. So basically, the roulette gives to the casino 5% edge in the market.
And they're focusing on the volume.
Exactly.
Long term, that's exactly what we do.
Exactly, exactly. Game. I mean, if you go to the casino with like $10,000 and bet it once, you may make, let's say, 50K, all right, profit. But in the long term, let's say a $10 million bets, the casino knows for sure that they will make $500,000 profit. So the 5% margin. But that's why all the time they win. They have the exact, nothing is changing. The exactly same things with our conditions is trading. Nothing is changing after you develop the strategy. Nothing will change. The condition will remain all the time the same. So think about this. If the casinos are making so much money with only 5% edge in the market, think about trading. Think about that if you find an edge in the market, you can be the casino. And the only thing that matters from that point is the volume, how many trades you execute.
Exactly.
And you don't need to do anything but anything else. Think about this. If you have like just a super simple strategy with a one-to-one risk-to-reward ratio and 52.5% win rate, you are as good as a casino. And this sounds crazy. I mean, this is like sounds like a stupid trading strategy. What is that? I will never trade you this. But guys, you are as good as a casino if you have a trading system with 52.5% win rate and one-to-one risk-to-reward ratio.
Let's be real. In this industry, being break-even, it's better than 90%.
Exactly.
Just a break-even.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly. But that's what I'm saying. Okay, trading can be gambling. It's fair enough. But think about that you can be the casino. If you have an edge in the market, 52.5% with a one-to-one put you in the exactly same level as a casino playing roulette. The only thing that you need to do is just execute as many trades as possible.
Build some volume in trades. And you can do it in long term only. That's
exactly. I mean, like, it's like the casino, if someone is coming betting like $10,000 and make 100K, let's say, what does it mean? The casino is going to get bankruptcy. Of course, if they have only a bankroll of 100K, then they will get bankruptcy. That's the negative strike in trading. Okay.
Yes.
So same things here. All right, if you go through a negative strike, because you have a perfect money management, because you know the statistics that you have, you'll be able to apply a money management. And if, for example, even 10 losing trades in a row come, you'll be able to continue trading to complete the volume in order to turn the percentages of wins in your favor.
Exactly. And to make such statistics, you need some no variables. They can't change. And this is where most traders I know are very, very...
it's basically when you need to take decisions.
Yeah,
like
they differ.
They differ
all the time.
It's just depending on your
mood.
Maybe
you woke up with a bad mood. Maybe you lost all the rest of the day yesterday and went to revenge.
Or maybe you just, guys, today you didn't looking at the 5 minute charts like you do all the time, and you just looking at the 15 minute charts. Or you combine, I don't know what type of charts and so on, and you just saw something else. So you see, that's a variable. All the time you take decisions. So if you take decisions, just hear this out. You can never, ever, ever, ever will be able to say that you have an edge in the market. It doesn't exist. The only edge in the market you can have if you are the roulette. So it's black, red, zero, and double zero. Those are never changed. It's not, it may be black or it may be white. All right, it may be red or it may be blue. That doesn't exist. Those are the colors, those are the numbers, that's it.
Yeah.
Same things here. What we do with statistics and probabilities. Those conditions are never gonna change. They will be all the time the same. There is no interpretation. There is no decision whatsoever. And tell me a little bit about, you know, the emotional side. I was like, Maybe you can give us, you know, an example how it was trading before and how it's trading now, when you know that you have, you know, control.
Exactly. Yeah.
In matter of like stress, emotion, anxiety, how you are with, you know, other people. Maybe you're angry, or because I've been there.
Yeah. Let's start at the beginning with the time spent at the computer. That's very important. That the more time you spend, the more energy you lose, and you get more tired. You start to make mistakes. With the approach we trade here, this time is very, very comparing what other traders spending 10 hours to looking for the right setup do. We do like 10 times less time at the screen, except when we are looking for the edge. That's the topic for next. You don't have like right picture when you just trade based on some kind of key market level, some order blocks, some, you know, all the smart money kind of type, where on any time frame you can look for many other decisions. And especially if you're a new trader, you don't know whether those decisions are right. And they are not right or wrong because they change all the time. And you can't expect any outcome. And, you know, best aid against the fear is the information. And we don't have the information if we don't have statistics. And to have statistics, you have to make nice conditions without any variables. If you don't have this, you're frightened to trade. You don't know the outcome. You don't know what to expect. You can't plan anything. And even if you get the negative strike, making decisions, constantly making wrong decisions, you cannot expect that something will change. How can you know that positive strike will come? And there's no way to know that. And you are always trading in a fear, let's say, and there is no, like, you don't know the destination.
Yes.
Because in the long run, we do know the destination. You are, you just know the edge. Yeah.
And again, you said about negative strikes. Negative strikes, you know, are more important than positive strikes, all right?
This is true.
Negative strikes, if you don't know the statistics of your trading system and you have a negative strike, you may lose the whole account into that negative strikes. Because we get back to money management, and you see that everything is about this money management in trading. Because I'm 100% sure you heard online, all the people in online talking about trading is 90% charts and 10% charts and 90% money management. That's true, but you cannot make money management if you don't have like a strategy that has condition that will never change. Because if you have a negative strike and you have a higher risk than what strategy is allowing you to use, you may lose the entire account into that negative strike. So it's very important to know the negative strike, and you can know the negative strike only if you have a strategy based on statistics and probabilities, based on some conditions that will basically
never change. And many traders are making this called trading journal, where they're journaling, that's not statistics what they're journaling, they're journaling their decisions. And what they then try to get out of that statistics, how good are they at making decisions? And then when you tell them about consistency, they don't understand consistency the way we do. They say, it depends on market conditions. This is what I have received many times when I say, yeah, I'm consistently profitable trader. And they say, you cannot be consistently profitable. This term doesn't exist because market conditions change. But this is not the truth if you have accounted that prior, because having correct data, not made by you, not your decisions, but the objective data, which then tells you what to do.
So, in short words, that journal, it's useful for you guys if you take decisions. Like the exactly same things with backtesting, okay? Like, when you do backtesting, because I used to do this like When I used to trade in the exactly same way, technical analysis and so many other concepts, when required decisions, I had so many journaling and all the time the backtesting. But that's not real. That backtesting not real, because basically,
you backtest also without emotions.
Exactly, you backtest without emotion, and you already saw what happened.
Yeah.
So you take decisions based on what market will do. So if you take decision based, if you take trades based on what market will do, that means you already saw what market will do. So let me give you this example. Like, if you have a strategy that is telling you when you see, let's say, a triangle, all right? Like, let's say a triangle. You see an uptrend, and then you see a triangle.
It's squeezing.
It's breaking the triangle, and it's going to go up. So this is your strategy. Now, if you go back, you're only going to look for this setup. And guess what? You're going to find this setup so many times. With like all the time, guys, taking the break, restore your 1-2, whatever.
1-2.
And it's super profitable on the paper. It's super profitable. But guess what? When you start like put it in a real market condition, you're going to lose money. And I'm telling you why now. Just think about this. If your strategy will be basically, when you see this pattern, maybe you're looking for a double top and then a breakout down or stuff like that. Guys, on the exactly same pattern, you will find another pattern that will tell you that the price will go down. Do you understand? In the exactly same pattern. And you go backtesting and you find all of these patterns, and at the end of the backtest, you are profitable. But guess what? Now you are in the market. The market is moving and is forming this triangle, but it also looks like maybe like a double top or triple top. So the triangle will tell you to buy, the double top or triple top, whatever, will tell you to sell. What do you do now? You see? Now you need to take decisions. So that's why, do you understand? So that's why there is no way as that backtest to be real, guys, because when you do backtest, you see exactly what happened and you know exactly what you're looking for, and you're only going to find those patterns. But when the market is moving, you will have a lot of situations when it will be like nothing clear. But on the other side, when you trade based on statistics and probabilities, such a thing doesn't exist. And that's why our backtesting, it's real, because it doesn't matter if I see what happened or if I don't see.
Yeah.
I never take decision in the backtest. I never take decision right now in the market condition whatsoever. Not even a small one.
Exactly. I mean, you know exactly when to trade. Because many traders, if they are looking for that pattern, they also feel an urge to trade that day.
Is that FOMO? Is that FOMO? Yeah. Oh, I need to enter now.
And if they miss the setup, and I would have been so right now. How did I? And then they not to have this feeling again. They start to see something. Oh, it's kind of forming, but it's not actually. Oh, I will trade it because of, I don't want to experience that feeling that how huge profits I could make right now, and this is a total disaster.
I know. I mean, this is scary. Guys, when I'm thinking back now, when I used to trade like that, that's like a nightmare. You know, it's literally a nightmare. Like, give me headaches only when I'm thinking about such things. All that stress, what I'm doing now, watching the charts, watching the phone all the time.
Yeah.
Should I enter? Should I not enter? Let's wait a little bit more. Ah, I miss it.
Yes.
Or with the with the take profit and stop loss, you know, when you have like a higher risk to reward ratio and then close the trade manually, that's stupid shit. How you can close the trade? Doesn't exist such things, guys. All right, we also close trade manually, but it's based on condition. So we never decide, oh, today I'm feeling to close this manually because I'm thinking that
this feels for me it's not gonna reach the take.
Yeah,
I need to close the trade.
And guess what? When you did that, the market continue going up, and you say, ah, fuck, I should wait, I should no, you know.
And then next time they wait.
That's the funniest part.
Yes, and then it goes to the minus.
And then the next time you say, oh, I saw that, now it's gonna go up, and you don't close. Because you wait, like last time it went, indeed, in your take profit. And now you wait, and guess what? Go against you, and you lose. And you lose. Ah, I knew that can happen, and why I didn't close it. No.
And trading should not be this emotional.
This is,
it has to be emotionless.
This is crazy. It has to be boring, guys.
Yeah.
If you have feelings, if your heart is pumping just like this,
when you open the trade, not being sure what you're doing,
give up of that, because it's not good for health and it's not good for your pockets. That's for sure, guys. All right. And you know, it's funny because I remember myself. Okay, I'm not laughing on you guys. All right, I'm laughing on myself, thinking back how I traded like for 5 years.
Thankfully,
that's a lot of time.
Yeah, and thankfully George saved me many years by not letting to go this route, even though I was aware, well aware about how most majority of retail traders trade. Thanks to George, I was able to go right to the path. Well, there is not right or wrong. There are many ways how to you can profit in the market, but you need to look into your understand what logic you as a person have, what makes sense to you. And I think this should make sense to most of the traders. In the end, it's not only about the sense, but about making money. You have to...
It's about make money. And, you know, I say this many times. This is not the only trading concept that you can make money out of it, guys. This is the concept that will help you out making money more easier, much faster, and less stressful.
Sleeping at night.
That's the only thing, guys. There are so many traders that are making money. But, you know, if you like to all the time be in that, oh, what I'm going to do now, what now, what now, what now, what now, those huge wins, those huge losses, you know, that can occur with that type of, you know, type of trading, stressful, and be all the time in alert. Look, if you want to do this, there are so many people, most probably, that are doing money. Most of them not, but there are people that are making money. In my point of view, I don't want to make money that way. It's gone. Like if I will need right now to choose to make money in that way or not make money at all, look, maybe sound crazy, but I will say no to that. That stress, you don't know the difference because you don't know how is to trade without stress, guys. All right? You don't have any idea how is to trade with
zero.
That's it. Zero. A big, big zero stress. All right. That's why you don't know how it is. So that's why when I'm thinking back, that stressful life, I don't want to make money in trading in that way. There are so many other ways that you can make money.
And maybe you will spend all of it in health later on, trying to help yourself mentally and physically as well.
That's for real, especially mentally. And when I lost everything, guys, I don't know how I didn't go to depression. That's real. Those are real things. Because it can give you, it can make you like a gambler addicted, guys. That type of trading style, there is no difference between you and a gambler.
Yeah, and especially when I see some very, very new traders that once start to trade, and if they lose a lot of money, they never recover because of those losses, emotional and just losing everything. They can't start it over. And why they got so far to lose is because at the beginning most of them were winning. And then I'm saying to them, you better be losing at the start. You would save a lot of time, nerves, money. Better lose at the start and give up if you're not planning to recover after this.
Exactly.
Like
that's,
you did.
That was hard. That was, you know, that was close to like go to hell.
If you wouldn't recover, then much, much better scenario would be if you would lose like right away.
Exactly. So guys, if you just started trading, and when I'm saying started trading, it's like if you are 1 year in trading, you just started to trade, all right, in my opinion, okay? So if you have 1 year in trading, you just started to trade. So if you lost money and you saw this video and wanted to really try something else, guys, you need to be the happiest in the world right now. Because sooner or later, you have such a higher chance to lose everything. For me, it happened after 5 years. So after 5 years, my entire world just collapsed. It was not just about money, I'm saying this all the time. It was about 5 years that I just basically everything I did, there was no life, there was no parties, there was no like, there was nothing, there was no life.
Pure
it was
grinding,
just
yeah.
Work and trading to put money in trading because we didn't have platforms back then. So everything you could do is just, you know, that was 5 years. And when I lost that, everything vanished. My dream to become a full-time trader just wipe out after I became a full-time trader. Because at that point, when I had those money, I already quit my job, you know, I saw myself, I'll be a full-time trader.
Waiting for the right setups.
Yeah, right. So that was great. But it was only that small thing to just basically go through a negative strike, go through impulsivity, go to FOMO and lose everything. And everything vanished in not even two weeks. So if you lost money, it's great because you lose it now and it's gonna save a lot of money from you, a lot of time and a lot of mental health. Okay, so
it's something that you can actually calculate. It's not like you don't know how it is going to look like. You will know it exactly how it is going to unfold. That's actually one of the beauties that I have discovered being in trading this way, that you have predictability, which is like how? In normal trading, it's impossible.
Yeah, in normal trading, you cannot have, but we are treating trading like business, guys. You know, I mean, like, maybe you watch so many interviews at my YouTube channel, and you can see there that, you know, our people from so many different domains, all right, smart people that are looking first to make an extra income, guys. All right, and I was saying in the beginning that it was great for him that he could keep his job. Guys, so not everybody wants to be a full-time trader. You know, maybe you have a great career that you work so much and you just want something extra. Maybe, you know, maybe you're a doctor, maybe you're a lawyer. That doesn't mean you need to not be a doctor anymore and start trading, be a full-time trader. Maybe not everyone wants to be a full-time trader. Maybe you have a business. You saw a lot of people there, even in the interviews, like quite big businesses, you know, and they still do trading and trade with us because they basically analyze everything. Everything starts to make sense, be logical. And, you know, give it a shot. And right now, they are making good money. But again, don't think about trading as you need to take, like, the worst decision in your life. And the worst decision in your life is to quit your job to become a full-time trader. All right? Sorry. So quitting your job to become a full-time trader is the worst decision that you could ever make. It will ruin you, guys, all right? And especially if you rely that much on that source of income. That's not at all the best thing that you can do.
And in the end, what are you going to do if you're going to quit your job? Because trading this way is not staring at the screen all the time. Like, there is actually no real need to quit the job.
I mean, like, if you...
In terms of time.
Yeah, if you quit your job, you'll trade 10 minutes per day. Guys, you don't need more than that. You understand? All right, let's say you have 4 strategies. Okay, you need 40 minutes a day. What do you do with the rest of the time?
Yeah.
Okay, maybe you want to travel. Okay, that's something else, they say. But come on, you cannot travel every single day. And you're going to get bored if you travel, if you spend time with friends or, you know, do hobbies. Well, come on, you're going to get bored, okay? So, guys, it's better to keep your job until, like, you make more money with those 10 minutes per day that you do with, like, 40 hours or more per week that you do at your job. Only if you want to quit your job, because maybe, again, maybe you love your job. There is absolutely nothing wrong to have a job that you enjoy doing it.
in the end, just choose the way that brings you happiness and you're passionate about it. It's very important just to follow your inner feeling, what you like to do. That's very, very important. If you're gonna hate trading, I don't really expect some good outcome in that way as well. Oh. Then better just stay at the job, bigger chances to make more money.
Yes, that's right. Like if you, you know, you don't need to be the most passionate trader in the world, like I am, for example, all right? But if you do trading, you know, just because you want really to make money and that's it, nothing else, you are not at all about passionate about, you know, investments, how money are working, you know, this type of industry, you know, that you're looking all the time to grow and stuff like that. If you hate doing trading, then just stop trading, because that's not gonna end well, all right? And there's no point for you to lose the time, lose the money, because it doesn't matter what you're doing, even if you join the mentoring program.
That doesn't mean you can do nothing.
Yeah, I mean, like, yeah. I have a full team that will really help you. Aivis can confirm, because he can also see them in the office.
Amazing
here.
Team. Nice
Thank
selection.
You. But, you know, in the end, Aivis, you can also say that, you know, it's also up to you. So yeah. We give you all the tools. We help you out. We exactly. push you from the back, you know, to get done, to help you out creating strategies and all that. But if you start the mentoring program and if you, I don't know, do maybe 1 hour a month of learning, that's not gonna.
And somehow you need to gather just data, and that takes a lot of time.
Yes.
You need to be committed to that.
So
as well.
Until we get to the finish of the mentoring program, you need to, you know, be commitment, work with your mentor, you know, do all the process. After that, trading will be 10 minutes, not even 10 minutes per day, all right? I'm trading like not even 10 minutes per day, not even 10 days a month, all right? So you're not gonna spend time on trading, but if you want to learn, you will spend time learning.
All the tools are being given, but the choice is actually yours, what makes most sense. And even though, when you understand the concept itself, even though you have gave up, every tool you have in the mentoring program, since you get grasped, you understand the concept, you can start to be creative and start to develop something even that's not in the program.
Exactly.
That's so, actually the beauty. It's not like it's very strict what's only there and there is like no other way how to make it. It's, for me, it was even like challenging. Let's figure out something that was not there. But when you totally understand the concept, you're becoming very good at it, and to become very good, you need to spend hours in front of chart. Not only placing trades, just technical parts, in which you also can make some mistakes, but the spending time in chart, you start to develop your eye to see some small, repeatable things that happen over time. You can utilize. Maybe you don't even know to do.
Exactly.
Have
maybe
the reason
maybe,
why
I,
it
maybe I don't know them. Yeah. You know, like you know, we had again because we had like a conversation yesterday when I was first time coming. You know, there are things in the market in those conditions that I don't see them. Like if I'm looking right now with him, he can see something else. You know, a small condition that I don't see, but he can see it, and that's why after you finish the mentoring program. This is what I like to say, that I can truly say that you are fully independent. Because Aivis can confirm, like, right now, you can create, Aivis, like, as many strategies as you want. You can identify as many conditions as you want on any market, on any assets. Maybe you can say, like, Aivis had, like, strategies on, show me yesterday, on Bitcoin.
Yeah, I trade Bitcoin, Ethereum, I trade the Euro, US dollar, I trade the SP 500, Dow Jones. Many, just whatever you like.
And on each of them, it's another strategy.
Yeah,
that's the beauty of this. On each of them, it's another strategy. So this is, you can diversify the risk. You can use so many fund accounts because it's easy to get it. You can basically have like 2-3 accounts that trade with this strategy, 2-3 that trade with this strategy. With this strategy, you can diversify everything. And you can create a strategy. I don't know if I'm going to give to Aivis right now that I want a strategy that will basically I need to place the trades at this hour on this asset, on this market, on this asset. He can create a strategy for me.
And it's not like you are, you're not the slave sitting in front of charts. You are the one who's deciding when to trade. And I trade before going to work and during the lunch break at my work. These are two time slots I trade. Then what I choose is the asset I like more. I like how it sounds, for example. Not because of the huge movement and huge volatility for gold, but I like to be a gold trader. I like to be a gold trader. It brings a lot of other good things that gold has as an asset. And knowing those things, and you don't necessarily need to know them because you will see with the time how it moves. And then you start to develop some patterns. You start to test it by the time you want and make it work for you. You're not working for, if the gold now decides to go up, I will do that. But it's like other way around. You are making this asset to work for you at what time you want, what risk you want. And sometimes it doesn't work with the strategy you wanted it to work. Just change the strategy, change conditions until it works. You have to put work into that. It's not that easy.
But you can make it work. It doesn't matter what asset. It doesn't matter what hour you want to trade. Yeah. And then it doesn't. So the asset will never dictate us the time when we need to trade.
That's real freedom.
So if you have a lunch break at 12, at 1 p.m., let's say, then you basically, let's say, you want to have, you want to trade at 1 p.m. because maybe you, at that point you have the lunch. Or let's say maybe you want to trade before, like you say,
New York Open.
Before going to work.
That's exactly.
Let's say you want to trade at 8 a.m. in the morning. So basically, you want to trade at 8 a.m. That's it. You have the first condition. The second condition, maybe for some reasons you want to trade, like I say, gold. I want to be a gold trader. Or maybe I want to trade Bitcoin. Or maybe I want to trade Euro USD, GBP, GPY, Dow Jones. Doesn't matter. The reason behind why to choose that asset, it doesn't matter. Because you like it. That's it. It doesn't need to be a reason. If you want to have a strategy on gold because you like to trade gold, and it's super interesting when you have a discussion and people ask you, what are you trading? You say gold. That's enough. So basically at 8 a.m. you're gonna trade on gold. And from that point, you'll start developing a trading strategy that is gonna make you money.
And you know that for sure it's gonna make.
Exactly. Because you have all the statistics, all the probabilities. Do you understand this? You have all the negative strikes. You have all of these things, guys, okay? So all of these things that you need. So in this way, you don't need to quit your job. You don't need to be stressed. We don't close trades or stuff like that. Everything is dictated by the strategy. Just to give you an example how it looks like, you grab your laptop, you open it. If you trade one asset, that's the simplest things ever.
Yeah.
All right. You just look in, okay, step one, step two, step three is done. Place the order, close the laptop. That's it. That's the all or all the all
depending
the
on the strategy, you cannot even check it on phone. You just check it when you at the evening, for example, how it went today.
Exactly. So that's the simplicity, and in this way you are able to basically, you know, keep your job, keep your business, and not just about this, but help you out developing other businesses. Guys, developing other businesses, you know, invest in something else. I mean, look at me. I mean, like, I don't know what to do in my time. I mean, like, I enjoy doing this, you know, developing Trading Busters community, involving myself even more and more because, you know, I have, like, people from the industry. Guys, it's great to talk about with people in the industry and have around you only people that are talking about trading. That's a great thing, okay? This gives me the chance because I don't trade that much, especially right now. I'm trading on Dow Jones. 5 minutes, not even 10 days per month. So just think about that time. But that time helped me out staying more with the people in Trading Busters, developing more funding dynasty, my own prop firm, also involving more and more into real estate, something a domain that I like a lot and I invested a lot lately. And so many other things, you know, basically, okay, family, traveling and all this stuff, right? So having trading only that much, it not just give you the chance to keep your job, but if you decide in the end to quit your job, it will give you the chance to basically develop other businesses.
Exactly.
Or do other things than just trading. Trading, it will remain for you at 10 minutes per day.
Or in some cases, if you're very passionate about trading, you can develop yourself in trading. You can create even more, start helping others.
Exactly, because it's important to, you know, for example, here at Trading Busters, I saw how important it is to have a mentor. And he meet Marius, because Marius is here with us at the office for these 2 days. So he saw that Marius is very passionate about this, and he really enjoy helping people. It's not just about you know, being in behind the you know, the camera.
And it was for me very interesting to see how things work from other side, how Marius is actually doing his job, how is he helping others, compare how he was helping to me, for example. And it was really nice to talk in person. Then everything changes, you know, everything when remote, when you meet the person, everything changes a lot.
Like you saw, Maris, it's not about that, you know, somebody's paying you to do this job. It's, you cannot pay someone to only do this, all right? Because he's like making enough money and all this stuff, but
he's a trader himself.
Exactly. Yeah. So, but he's, he really likes what he does, all right? He enjoyed, you know, speaking with people. We are talking about trading. We are around only surround only with people in this industry. And that's why I'm saying that the mentors, guys, that you will meet here at Trading Busters, they like, they want to give back to the community. It's not just about that, you know, they are making some extra money because they are mentors. It cannot be just about that, because they are making enough money as traders. But you need to want to get back, to give back to the community.
Yeah, exactly. And kind of regarding the mentors itself, they are really like the people in their own place. And they are the, which was very interesting. I come from professional background in the corporations, and there is what I noticed first I started the program, that the response rate the mentors have is amazing. Sometimes I was doing some backtesting after the work in the late evening, and I had some question, and I was like, well, I still have this idea, I will just text my mentor. And we'll wait at the business hours when mentor will reply, because this was the normal how in corporate world things work. And I got like answer in 5 minutes, and then I felt like wrong disturbing the person. But this person loves trading, he's passionate about the trading, and he's this shows how much mentor is committed to help you. He just, if the question is easy, why not to answer now? It might help him because he appreciates person putting work.
Exactly.
And if he sees you put a lot of work, he will do maximum.
He's like, you know, Marius, we have a lot of mentors, but, you know, Marius is staying here with us in Bucharest and is with us at the office most of the time. And, you know, I see him sometimes, he's upset. Okay, like, Marius, oh, he doesn't want to try harder. He doesn't, come on, like, why are you upset about this? You know, like, he really like to push people, and he really want to see people that, you know, ask him questions. He enjoy when people are asking questions and ask for meetings and all this stuff. Because, yes, we have so many successful traders in the mentoring program, but not all of them can be mentors. Because to be a mentor, it's not enough to be a good trader, you know? It's great to be a good trader, but so many people, you know, I make so much money in trading, I'm developing other businesses, I'm traveling, I don't want to show my face, I don't want someone else to bother me, and there is absolutely no problem, okay? So that's why when we choose a mentor, because we choose mentors from the people in the that just got the mentoring program, and they are very good at that, but also, you know, you need to want to give back to the community, all right? Like I would say, you know, he texted and Marius respond like when he got the message, because he enjoyed doing this, all right? He's not saying, oh, another message. Yeah. It's like, okay, let's discuss. It's trading. I'm doing trading. You are doing trading. Let's discuss about trading. Let's see how we can get better.
And in the end, there are not that many people doing trading. Yeah. If you're expert in trading, good luck. You find person on the street you can talk about this. If you have someone to talk about trading, it's great already.
Yes, and it helps them also. Okay, think about this. You know, how many things can he find out also? So basically, each and every mentor enjoy this type of meetings because you are talking with another person that wants to be a successful trader or maybe already is making money in trading and basically wants even more. All right? So only good things can come out from that conversation. A lot of conditions, a lot of new things that you can see. So, because again, it's up, you know, sometimes some people see so many great conditions and open your eyes even more, yeah. even more. So that's why the mentors are really loving what they are doing. The exact same things like me. I love to, you know, help out the community, push trading busters even more because it's really nice to have people from everywhere around the world see them succeed.
Yes, and this community is really about making you successful. That's what I have felt from the first day when I joined here. And since you feel this vibe about getting, they really want you to get successful. And as a thank you, I would like to also help others. First of all, get good myself. And then if I'm good, why not to help others? To give back, and this is hard to maybe for some people understand why you want to give back to the community and what that actually means until you are there yourself. When you get good at it, you see, oh, I understand every concept. I can even help other guys right now. And I can discuss with my mentor some things that he didn't see, maybe how can you do it that way? Then we both grow. And if we discover both something new, why not to share with the community?
That's basically, guys, you know, the next stage of success. Like after you become successful, you want like to show people that you know.
Yeah.
And you enjoy when people say thank you, I did it. You know, when you help someone and that person succeed, when that person say I did it, thank you, guys, like nothing can compare with that. Like that's the that's like serotonin in your brain, you know. That's it. So it's like a great feeling when you see people succeed. So that's basically want to give back to the community all the time and helping other people. It's like the next stage after success. And these things can only make you better. That's it. It can only make you better because you will be able to, again, say this, because I'm saying this many times because this is so important. To surrender yourself with people,
like-minded people
that want more for life.
Exactly.
They are so happy when you succeed because maybe you. I mean, like we are living in this world. If I'm go right now, and say to some people how much money I'm making, do you think they will be happy? They will not be happy, all right. They will be. I will ruin their days, all right. So they will go upset home. But when you say here, with my community, you say, I'm making that much, he's making that much. People are saying, whoa, yeah. well done. I want to make more also. How can we help each other? So you see, that's the vibe. Those are the people that you need to surround yourself with. People that are so happy for your success and the only thing that they are thinking of, how can I get better also, you know? But maybe you can tell right now to your friends, I'm making this much, and maybe they're not even going to talk with you about anymore, all right? Or maybe you
or
see...
Or will think they lie.
Yeah, you know? Or you do. Ah. You see? So that's the difference, guys. And that's why I like to putting a lot of work and a lot of time into Trading Busters, because I grow this community and I'm bringing this community only people that, you know, want to grow. That's why Aivis now, yes, he come in the mentoring program through this way like everyone else. You cannot just go on the website, put your credit card there, buy it, and that's it. No, it doesn't exist. I don't want such people in my community. First, you need to go through one-on-one, okay? We need to see each other, we need to see you, it's on Zoom. We need to see you, to see your face. You can also see our face, you know. You can see the person that you are talking to, okay? It's very important to look in the eyes and see, you know, what type of persons we are, what type of people we are here at Trading Barcelona, and also see how you are. Because I can tell you, if you are negativist and all the time looking for, you know, bad things to happen, there is no place for you here.
Guess what's going to happen? Exactly what you are thinking all the time about bad things. If you think good things,
exactly,
guess what? Good things will happen.
We don't want bad vibes here. Like, I mean, like, if you know, the domain is already hard. If people are come only with negativity and only, oh, it's not gonna work, it's not gonna, that's fine. Okay, this is not for you.
Just, yeah, even though we would like to help you. Yeah, sorry, you made your own decision, let's say.
Exactly. So that's why, you know, people cannot come into my community, and that's why so many people succeed, because it's an entire process. I say this many times, you know, in so many videos, that my mentoring program, it's a process. It's not about buying an online course. So from the first interview that you have with someone from my team, you can see us. And guys, if you don't like how we are thinking, how we are speaking or something, that means that is not good for you from the beginning. Exactly, you need to enjoy speaking with us, all right? So if you don't enjoy speaking with a person from my team, that may be a great sign that, look, this is not for me, all right? Because here it's everything is about people. It's not just about that you go and watch those videos. Everybody in the team has the same mentality, you know, the same energy, the same goals. So that's why it's important for you to take a decision also on the people that you are speaking to see, because if you like them, that's mean, you know, it's the first step to move forward. So this interview, this one-to-one meeting is good for you also because you can take an informed decision. And for us also because we can see you. And, you know, if you are a person that meet the conditions that we have, then of course you are more than welcome in the community.
Yeah, and one of the real proofs that they are real is because I'm here. They are real. George is real.
Yeah, I'm like, this is too good to be true. I'm like, guys, can you imagine this? This is becoming a little bit frustrating, let's say, maybe for me. Because I'm hearing this a lot lately. I mean, like, oh, you know what? So I like this, I like that, I like that, I like you. But I think this is a scam. This is too good to be true.
Yeah, we were talking about this yesterday as well. what then you should tell?
Does it, come
what
on,
else you should
I'm
tell?
Like, guys, we are for real here. We are here for real, and people are making money because, like you see, it's a process. It's not just something you go, you buy a course. Maybe you watch it, maybe you don't. Maybe you don't understand something, you message some persons to support, nobody will answer to you, and then you give up, and then you that. No. So from the beginning, you have a meeting, you can take an informed decision. So it's not everyone is coming in the mentoring program. That's why so many people succeed, because from the beginning, we choose people that are on the same size, and we know this person, we can help. So if you are, you know, motivated, want to succeed, open mind, we can help you make money. If not, we cannot. So you're not gonna come, you're not gonna pass that first stage, all right? So that's why a lot of people succeed, because we eliminate like maybe 60-70% of the people that are joining that call. So that's why we keep only people that, you know, we strongly believe that we can help them. That's the first thing. Then with the mentoring program, we're also giving you a funded account. And with the funded account, we give you access to buster signals and, you know, let you to place the buster signals on the funded account So basically, you don't have that pressure on your shoulder. Oh, I'm doing the mentoring program, and now what? I need to make to make another investment to make money, because you know, in trading, money makes money. No, you have already founder account, so that pressure is gone. Then you have the pressure. Okay, I have the founder account, but I need to learn very fast because I need to make money. And you can start rushing the prices, and that's not a good thing. That's not a good thing. But I give you the chance to place buster signals on the founder account, so you can start making money even in the next day. So there is no pressure on your shoulder also to rush the process in learning. So you can learn in peace, take your time, do everything perfectly. In the same time, you are making money while you learn trading on the founder account that I provided with the buster signals, first withdrawal after 1 month, then each and every withdrawal can be at 2 weeks. So you see, that's why people succeed, because it's an entire process. It's not just buying an online course and that's it.
Yeah. One thing I want to add from my experience when I just joined, that was exactly what happened, founded the account and the buster signals. And what it helped me a lot was I kind of saw, I was not through the mentoring program yet, but I saw inside how it will look. On average, how time I will spend, all the time, every day, single time. And this like was great insight to see how trading this way will look I have started.
Yeah, because this
program
can also motivate you that you can get and have the exactly type of strategies, guys. You know, I mean, like, you can see with buster signals, trading every single day at the same hour, placing the orders, put your phone in the packet.
And by the learning, you at first you don't understand how, why there, why we trade like this. And when you start to learn, it slowly unfolds.
It starts sense.
This is why they did this. This is why it's exactly take profit is exactly there. Why there is no take profit 2,500, only one, and everything starts to unfold. And you also get some experience executing trades, because if you are very good at creating strategy but not disciplined to execute it good, also not going to be good results. So execution also important part.
Exactly.
Knowing the platforms, how to calculate position size.
You can know all of these, guys. You know, I mean, like with this process, you see? So you're not going to join the mentoring program and then wait, learn, rush the process, put your own money back in risk, a lot of stress, quitting your job in the same time. Do you see this? Just think about what this will mean. Join the mentoring program and then need to put another money into trading. Rushing the process in learning how to trade because, okay, you have the money, but you don't have the strategy. You rush the process. You don't have a good strategy. Mm-hmm. You say, okay, it's good enough. Let's get started. Then maybe quitting your job. So this is a huge pressure on your shoulder. But in this way, with this process, we eliminate all of this. How do I know this, and why I make this program like this? Because yes, it's just basically what I've been through. All right, I've been through all of this, and I knew how much this could help me. I'll probably have like more figures in my accounts if I will have that point when I started, for sure. But you know, that's the process. That's why so many people succeed, and that's why, you know, people say, okay, it's too good to be true. Guys, we are here.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
regarding the rushing the process, me as a student, it's very important not to rush the process. Trust the process and like the process, like the journey, enjoy the journey, learn things, because you don't need to rush. You are executing and doing trades, also gaining some experience how to do it. And When you want to trade this way, you have to trust in your system. But to have a good system, you have built your own. Of course, the mentor will check it. But you have to put some ideas, some experience, some work.
Because
this takes time.
That's all about.
And improve the confidence.
Exactly.
Your confidence.
To be fully independent. Because otherwise, you could just basically place just buster signals and that's it.
Yeah.
But that's not the point of the mentoring program.
Or sometimes, you will create some strategy, maybe not well thought through, and you will start to trade maybe strategy that is not optimal because you did not put enough effort and time to tailor it. Because you have to test many other small details, maybe. Small detail can change a lot. And it usually
a
does.
Lot.
It does a lot.
A small change can...
And what happened, for example, for me, I just decided, I created the strategy, started to trade it. By trading it, I found this, if I would not have trade this 1 month, or I could just wait, while in this month I learned more and more knowledge and tailored it perfect, now it would be 2 times better. And since we look in the long term, it's better to trade great system you trust in the long term from right start, not changing in the middle.
Exactly.
Because that's the edge we were talking in the beginning.
Yeah, so that's why there is, you know, is no point of rushing this, because you have buster signals, place them, make money, and take your time basically to develop not a good strategy, but a very good strategy. There is absolutely no rush. That's why, again, I'm saying these people are succeeding, because All these small things, guys. Those things are making the difference between being a profitable trader or losing money in the market.
But it's also important not to exaggerate too much, because the losses are normal, and you can also spend too much time trying to perfect tailor. But everything has losses, and
perfection doesn't exist.
Also, you know? You have to be in a kind of sweet spot in this, where you have very good, well-tested system you trust. Also, you have not spent like a year of trying to build something unrealistic. Simplicity is very important.
The simplicity is very important,
because sometimes you can make a strategy, you change some detail, but that detail is so specific and it's hard to remember, but you gain only really, really small percentage of the win rate. Because of that small detail, maybe better to remove it.
Exactly.
Keep it simple.
Yeah, what I would say is, like, you know, sometimes, you know, he's like a level right now when, you know, he can change a bit and make the strategy, like, let's say, just a simple example, from 80% win rate, he can go, if he change that to 80.05%. So what he's saying is, like, is reading that 0.5% worth it to make a change? So, you know, if it's not really worth it, if it's not going to increase the win rate, for example, good enough, it's better not to do it and just accept that there will be those losses there. And that's it, you know? So, it's important to understand that the losses are there. And when you have a trading system based on statistics and probabilities, you will start understanding that those losses are just a part of the business, are super normal.
It's like
it's something bad that if they don't happen, okay? And so you don't feel anything when you lose. Nothing. You don't feel anything. You lose, you don't feel literally anything. You know, because you understand that that's normal. You know that will happen. You know that will happen, okay? But you were okay from the beginning. You just, next day, what you do? Open the laptop, place the same trade. Day after, open the laptop, place the same trade. Because you have calculated your risk management, that loss, that strike will never affect you. And just basically, the only thing that you need to do is just be there each and every time when the system will tell you, place the trade, and that's it. We discussed a lot. I want to thank you for visit us.
Thank you for inviting.
It's great to have you here. It's our first podcast also. Yes, maybe you want to leave us in the comment if you want me to, you know, bring more students here in Bucharest to, you know, stay with us at the office, experience this trading floor feeling and so on. And of course, you know, make an interview like face to face. Tell me in the comment if you want us to, you know, do more this type of podcast.
Thank you for inviting here. It was really nice time here in Bucharest, meeting you, meeting my mentor. And it was definitely great time I spent here. Besides what I have learned so much in this trading program, and I'll be very, very thankful for the opportunity you gave and nice atmosphere over here. And thanks for watching.
Thank you, guys, and please leave it a comment if you want us, Trading Busters, you know, to have more podcasts and interview more of our members.